बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? वे वी विल स्टडी यूनिट नंबर 6, सब्जेक्ट साइंस, पेज नंबर 27। यूनिट नेम इज लुकिंग आफ्टर योर सेल्फ। टुडे टॉपिक इज कीपिंग हेल्दी। There are many cells in our body which fight against harmful microorganisms. They work only if you are healthy and strong. If you are strong, it will work. It will fight against harmful microorganisms. So you can look keeping healthy. First paragraph. There are cells in your body which fight against harmful microorganisms. These cells can only work if you are healthy and strong. Here are some ways to keep healthy. Make a habit of washing your hands with soap and plenty of water before and after having a meal, and especially after using the toilet and after sneezing and coughing. If you use toilet, you must wash your hand. If you use the toilet, you must wash your hands. If you are taking a meal, or if you are taking a meal, before meal and after the meal, wash your hands. After sneezing and coughing, wash your hands. Eat a variety of healthy foods. Take different types of food. Keep food away from flies and dust. Food must not be exposed to insects. Sneeze into handkerchief or a tissue. Breathe in fresh air and play outdoor games. Make sure the water you drink is boiled and clean. Drink water before drinking water. Boil the water. Go to see your doctor regularly. Visit the doctor regularly to check your height and weight regularly. So go to see your doctor regularly to have your height and weight checked regularly. Go to dentist regularly to have your teeth checked. Visit the doctor regularly that he must check your weight and height, and visit the dentist also on regular basis. Preserving food. Preserving usually involves preventing the growth of bacteria, fungi, and other microorganisms. A number of methods of prevention can be used that can either totally prevent, delay, or otherwise reduce food spoilage. There are several ways in which we can stop or slow down the decay of foods. Preserving food means to reduce the growth rate of microorganisms or bacteria, or to stop it or to reduce it. That means preservation of food. First, how you can preserve food by freezing. Food will go bad if they are left uncovered or not refrigerated. If you keep food in the freezer, it will be preserved. This is the way of preserving food. Microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi begin to grow in them if they are not preserved, if they are not at proper temperature. Microorganisms need certain condition to grow. They cannot grow in food that is kept dry or frozen. Most types of food, including meat, fish, and some fruits and vegetables, can be preserved in the refrigerator. canning and bottling. If the food has been sterilized, it is sealed so air cannot enter. Since no more bacteria or fungi can get into the can or jar, the food will last for many months or even years. So preservation of food is first sterilized and then sealed the bottles properly so that no bacteria or fungi can get into the can or jar. The food will last for many months. You preserve the food for many months or even years. Chemical preservatives. Some food can preserve by adding certain chemicals to them, such as salt, sugar, vinegar, etc. Salt is used to preserve meat. Sugar is used to preserve fruits and jams. Vinegar is added to pickles so they stay fresh and safe to eat for months. Pasteurization is a process in which water and certain packaged and non-packaged foods are treated with mild heat, usually to less than 100 degrees Celsius, to eliminate microorganisms and extended shelf life. So pasteurization is the process in which water and certain packaged and non-packaged foods are treated with mild heat, usually to less than 100 degrees Celsius, to eliminate microorganisms and extend shelf life. Milk can be preserved for a while by a process called pasteurization. Milk is pasteurized by heating it at 60 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. The microorganisms in the milk are killed and it becomes pure enough to be drunk without boiling. Pasteurization is preservation of food by heating. Pasteurization is a process in which water and certain packaged and non-packaged foods are treated with mild heat, usually to less than 100 degrees Celsius, to eliminate microorganisms and extended shelf life. Milk can be preserved for a while by a process called pasteurization. If you heat milk for 30 minutes at a temperature of 60 degrees Celsius, you will preserve it for some duration of time, and the growth of bacteria will not take place for some time, for some duration, or for short duration of time. So pasteurization is the preservation of food by heating. Thank you, students. It's finished. Let's revise it, what we study in this chapter. The unit name is looking after yourself. First, in this we study microorganisms. The diagram shows different types of our microorganisms. You studied that bacterium, virus, and fungus are microorganisms. The branch of physics science that deals with the study of microorganisms is called microbiology. And a person who studies microbiology is called microbiologist. Some microorganisms causes disease, which may result in death. Microorganisms and disease. Microorganisms that causes disease are called pathogen. These pathogens infect other organisms and cause various signs and symptoms in the organisms. some disease spread from person to person or through other organisms, including those caused by virus and fungi. They are called infectious disease. For example, measles, chickenpox, ringworm, dengue fever, etc. Types of microorganisms: bacteria, virus, protozoa, fungi. Disease caused by microbes can also be called pathogens. Germs or bugs are responsible for causing infectious disease. Protozoa are unicellular organisms. If they enter the body, they can live and grow there. They grow in mosaic places and are commonly found in water. Disease caused diarrhea, dysentery, nausea, and vomiting. Viruses, smaller than bacteria. Viruses can grow and survive only when they are in the living cells of organisms. They multiply rapidly in warm and moist places. The disease caused by viruses is displayed on the screen. Influenza, chickenpox, cold, measles, mumps, hepatitis, corona. Bacteria are unicellular organisms. They grow and multiply very rapidly. They can make you ill. Disease caused by bacteria is food poisoning, tooth decay, pneumonia, and typhoid, etc. Fungi are multicellular organisms. They can be both microscopic and macroscopic. Some of them, like mushroom, can be eaten, but some are poisonous. You need to keep your skin clean to avoid such disease. You can read. Disease caused by fungi. Athlete's foot and ringworm. How microorganisms enter the body? By nasals, through injury, urine, through urine, stools, insect bite, and through injections. Through the air, through direct contact, through contact with contaminated surfaces, contaminated food or water. Keeping healthy. This is today's topic. There is precautionary measures that you should take if you want to stay healthy. You can see. You should drink boiled water and drink water when you drink water, first boil it and then drink. Visit your doctor regularly to check your height, weight, and also visit dentist regularly. Preserving food. Preservation of food means to stop the growth of bacteria and other microorganisms. You can stop the growth of some bacteria, and in some places you can reduce the growth. You cannot stop, but you can reduce. Freezing is one way that is used for preserving food. You can see in the diagram. Canning and bottling. If the food has been, so before canning, food must be sterilized. Then it is sealed that air cannot enter. So even bacteria and fungi cannot enter into the can or jar. The food will last for many months or even year if it is preserved in this way. There is chemical preservatives. Chemicals used for the preservation of food is called chemical preservatives. Salt is used to preserve meat. Sugar is used to preserve fruit and jams. Vinegar is added to pickles so they stay fresh and safe to eat for months. Pasteurization. Pasteurization is the process in which water and certain packaged and non-packaged foods such as milk and fruit juices are treated with mild heat, usually less than 100 degrees Celsius, to eliminate microorganisms and extend its shelf life. Milk can be preserved for a while by a process called pasteurization. Milk is pasteurized by heating it at 60 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. The microorganisms in the milk are killed and it becomes pure enough to drink without boiling. This is last topic of chapter. So thank you, students. Do revise.